Here we are. What is the standard deviation of the participant's age? Number 11. We go to our program data. Okay. Age standard deviation. I've got it for you in the yellow. We'll remember equals. We always start with equals. Standard deviation. STDEV. Open parentheses. Highlight my range. Close parentheses, enter or tab. Okay, again, just because that looks a little sloppy with all those decimal places, we're going to highlight this. We're going to go up to our number here and decrease the decimal. Let's go down to one. Okay. Back to my instructions. I can check that one off. Okay, how many participants from each program completed the evaluation? The programs are underwater diving, UDA, I don't remember, RS, I don't remember, and ARC is archery. Okay. So let's go back to our program data. Okay. Here again, we are counting the number of participants in each category. I have it over here for you on the left, already set up. Okay. Again, like we did earlier with males and females, we can sort and then count. But there's a better way. Okay, and it's a count if again. Okay. And I'm actually going to add another element to it here. So this will be here already when you open yours. Okay. Programs are UWD, UDA, RS, and ARC. Okay. So in the first context, I want to count everything that's UWD equals, or I'm going to say count if, open parentheses, highlight comma, because I got to tell it what I want it to count, right? Now I could here type in UWD, but what I like to do, which will make my life easier in a second, I'll show you why, is I just highlight this cell over here, which already has UWD in it. Close parentheses, tab, we have 165 participants. Okay. Now, the reason I didn't just type UWD in is now I can do a handy little trick, and as I do that, I'm going to teach you something else. Okay. I am going to go to the bottom corner of this and drag it down. So now Excel counts the UDAs because it's looking for that cell reference, the RSs, and the ARCs. Now, one catch with this, and here's another trick. You may not immediately notice, but these are not correct, and I'll show you. I sum these, I only get 383, which is correct. It's not correct, I promise. But here is why. Okay, Excel again tries to outsmart you. Okay, and the way it does that is when you drag this formula down, it automatically updates. So it went from the first cell, we count C2 to C384, which is correct. When we drag it down, when it goes C3 to C385, so now we're suddenly missing C2 in our calculation, and we don't even have anything in 385. Next one is C4 to 386. Now we're missing 2 and 3, but we don't have anything in 86. Here's how we could go back and manually change that, but here's how we do it to start with. Okay, so I'm going to go back to my initial formula. And I'm going to do what's called an anchor. I've heard it called something else, but it's an anchor. And an anchor is a dollar sign. And what that dollar sign or anchor does is tell Excel, when you copy this formula, when you copy this cell, do not change this thing. Okay? And we want the 2 to always stay. Remember, the 2 changed to 3 when we drug it down. We don't want it. We want it to stay 2. Okay? The 384 we want to change. We don't want it to be 385, 386, 387. So I'm going to put a dollar sign in front of the 2, and a dollar sign in front of the 384. Okay. I tab out. Now I will recopy this down. Okay. It's actually getting you the same answers. And the reason for that is just a fluke of luck, quite frankly. And it's because there were no UDAs in the top cell. There was no RSs in the top. You know, it was a total fluke. You know, but now these are correct. And I move on. Okay. calculate the average of the food ratings for each type of program. Okay, I go back to my data sheet. Okay, I have an average food rating for each type. I could sort, but something tells me there's another way to do this. And something tells me based on my COUNTIF function that maybe it says an if involved. So if that was a COUNTIF and now I'm doing an average, maybe, just maybe, it's an average if. Indeed it is. Surprise, surprise, right? Okay, equals average if, open parentheses. Now, this is a little bit more complicated because you've got multiple components to this. The first thing we need to tell Excel is, what are we looking for? Okay, we are looking for the type of program. Where are we looking for it? Type of program's over here. Okay, so we're going to highlight this range. Okay. Now, what are we looking for there? What's Excel looking for? Comma. We have to tell Excel what it's looking for. Okay, and in this case, it's looking for the UWD. Again, I can type it, but I'm going to make my life much easier by just highlighting the cell that has UWD. Okay, so now I've told Excel that we are looking for UWDs, and when we found a UWD, we're going to calculate the related score in the average. Now we have to tell it what score we're calculating. We're going to comma again. We're in food, so we're going to calculate. We're going to highlight all of food. And I'm going to click close parentheses and enter. Voila! The average food score for all our UWDs is 3.6 something. Again, I'm going to change the formatting by going up here, decrease decimal to 1. Okay. Now, again, we can drag this down, but you remember from last time, that'll actually get screwed up, and this time there's no fortuitous luck, I can tell you. Okay. So I want to put these anchors in. Remember, I don't want the 1 to change. I don't want the 384 to change. I do want the 391 to change, so that's here. So the next time I'm down, I want it to be on 392, 393, 394. Okay. I don't want this 2 to change. I don't want this 384 to change. Okay, anchors. So I've put my anchors in. Now I drag it down. Boom. There we go. Moving on. Based on the above calculations, what might you consider changing? Okay. Again, you may want to wait till class that, although you could probably figure this one out on your own. Create some space here. Just by hitting enter, I would change blah blah blah, whatever you change. Okay. Create a bar chart of averages of food by program type to show your supervisor. Display the, we're going to call it, we're going to change this to column. Bar chart on a separate sheet. Actually, we'll leave this as a bar. Oh, no, we'll call it. Already done there. Already gone there. Okay, back to my data. Okay, again, we could just, the easiest thing to do here is just highlight this little block right here. Insert column chart. Let's do a 2D one this time. Okay, boom, there it is. Again, I have to click on it, highlight it by just left clicking in, and then I right click, move chart to new sheet. Food averages by program. Bingo. Now it's on a new sheet. Let's update my title. I'm going to left click in there until it highlights. Food averages by type. Okay. Can add my data labels. I can do all kinds of fun things here that I won't do. Get out a trend line, which just shows us. This is not a time experiment. Ignore I said that. Sorry, I get carried away in Excel sometimes because it's fun. Okay. You're not laughing as hard as I'm laughing right now. Okay, check that off. Bam, I save it, I submit it, perfect score. If you have any questions, let me know. But hopefully these series of videos, you can just walk right through with it. We'll see you soon. Have a great day.